guess I'm going to walk. Oh, that milky white way. Oh, child, some of these days. Well, I'm going to walk that milky white way. Oh, some of these days. Well, 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 I'm going to walk up and take up my stand. Gonna join that Christian band. I'm going to walk, whoa, that milky white way. Oh, Lord, some of these days. I'm gonna tell my, oh, my mother, howdy, 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 when I get home. Yes, I'm going to tell my mother, howdy, when I get home. Well, 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 I want to tell my mother, hey, when I shake mother hand that day. That's when I walk, oh, that milky white way. Some of these days. I want to meet God the Father and God the Son. Yes, I'm one to be.
The table before me in the presence of my enemy. my head with oil. Increases strength. lay that weight upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. With thee, be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will help thee, yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Fear not, for I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by that name. That art mine. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee. And through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel. Thou Savior, the Lord is good. yet I live. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God? Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there ye may be also. And whither I go, you know. And away, you know. And Tolbert said unto him, Lord, we know not whether thou goest, and how can we know the way?
Show you a mystery.
shall all be changed in the moment, in the twinkling of an eye. And the last trump, for the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed. For this corruptible must put on incorruption, and this mortal must put on immortality. So when this corruptible shall have put on incorruption, and this mortal shall have put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written. Amen. For the family, friends of Mr. Theodore Tolbert, they have a program that they have outlined for us to go by, and they have not changed. So we will go in the order that it is printed. Him, Deacon Donald Tolbert, Prayer of Comfort, Pastor Johnny B. Dean, Old and New Testament Scripture, Pastor Morris Jones. Followed by the musical selection by Miss Jamie Porter and Miss Jamisha Porter.
Night of death draws near. Lay our garments by upon our beds to rest. So death will soon disrobe us all of what we here possess. Lord, keep us safe this night. Secure us from all fears. May angels guard us while we sleep till morning light appears. And when our days are past and we from time removed, oh, may we now in our bosom rest, the bosom of thy love. God Almighty, hear the sing of a prison for a prayer. May we upon our guest to rest, we
God, we come thanking you for Theodore's life, Lord God. We thank you for the lives that he touched throughout his craftsmanship, Lord God, serving man all over this community, God, giving of himself and being a blessing in the lives of many, God. So we pause just to say thank you. We thank you for his gift. We thank you for his kindness, Lord God. We thank you for his dedication to the family, Lord God. So it is in this hour we ask now, God, that you will strengthen this family. For even though it may seem sad, Lord God, but God, to be absent from this body is to be present with you, God. So God, we pray now that you will strengthen the family. Remind them, as David said, look to the hills from which cometh their help. All of their help cometh from thee, Lord. God, we thank you now. For we know if this earthly tabernacle of ours dissolves, we have another building not made with hands. So God, we realize that Theodore is not dead. He's just transitioning from life to life, Lord God. Again, we say thank you. Bless his children, Lord God. We know that you'll be a father for the fatherless. And oh God, bless his sister that walk with him day by day, Lord God. Continue to take care of him, Lord God. Bless the Tolbert family in this loss, Lord God. But God, we know that the comforter is the Holy Spirit. For we're together now, but we know that there are going to come time in the wee hours of the night that we're going to miss him, God. And we thank you, God, that the Holy Spirit will comfort you. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you right now, God. We thank you, God, that he's not in pain anymore, Lord God. He's not suffering, Lord God. He's not struggling, but he's at peace with you, God. So we bless you for it right now, God. Not our will, God, but your will have manifest here today, Lord God. So God, we celebrate his transition, Lord God. No more pain and no more sorrow, but give him rest. It's in Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen, amen, and amen.
Amen. Coming from the Old Testament, Job 19 25, 26. And they read, "For I know that my Redeemer liveth, and he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worm destroyed this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God." The New Testament, Revelation 3, 13 through 17. "And one of the elders answered, saying unto me, What are these which are arrayed in white robes? And whence come they? And I said unto him, Sir, thou knowest. And he said to me, These are they which came out of the great tribulation, and have washed their robes, and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. Therefore are they before the throne of God, and serve him day and night in his temple. And he that sitteth on the throne shall dwell among them. They shall hunger no more, neither thirst any more. Neither shall the sun light on them, nor any heat. For the Lamb which is in the midst of the throne shall feed them, and shall lead them unto living fountains of water. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes." Miss Porter, Miss Jamie Porter, and Miss Jamisha Porter. Amen. The next book we'll hear is as a family member, Mr. Cary Bowden, son-in-law. After that, as a co-worker, Elder Charlotte Dobbs of Southwest Georgia United Empowerment Zone. Then a family tribute, Commissioner Vesta Bill Shepherd. After that, a resolution, Trustee Aletha J. Askew. And after then, a music selection by Ms. Janet Porter and Ms. Jamisha Porter. And the next word you'll hear then after then would be the eulogy by Reverend Eddie James Tolbert.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
I'm gonna just get up here and say and get to the most important thing that I remember about my dad-in-law. We used to take trips and stuff to the VA, and we used to do a lot of talking on our way to the VA and on our way back. But whenever we did go and come back, and I know everybody knows this about my dad-in-law Vito, he always ends the conversation with, "If you need me, call me." And I'm like, "Nah, Dad, are we good?" No, no. He said, "No, just listen to me. If you need me, call me." I said, okay. And that was one of the most important things about him, that he was always willing to help others. No matter what he had to do, if he could help him, he would. And then when he got down real sick and he was out there in the nursing home, you know, I never known my father-in-law, you know, to go to church that much. I think the last time I remember him in church was when he went to one of his dear friend's funeral, Mr. Carr. And he was at the nursing home, he was real sick. And I took my Bible out there one day. And we were sitting there, you know, he was going in and out. You know, he couldn't remember too much at the time, then some things he could remember. But I sat there one day, me and him was talking, and I told him. I said, "Dad, I want to ask you something." And he said, "What that?" And I said, Do you believe that Jesus Christ was crucified, dead and buried, and on the third day he rose? He said, I do. He said, I believe that. And he said, I talk to Jesus all the time. That's what he told me. After he told me that, I was satisfied. I was satisfied. And one thing I leave it with y'all, like I used to always tell him, when I used to get ready to walk out of the room, I said, Daddy, don't start no trouble now. And one thing he would tell me, every time I asked him, I did that yesterday. I'm going to just tell you, don't start no trouble when you get up there. All right? Thank y'all.
Greetings in the name of Jesus. To the family, God bless you. I find myself honored to be asked to stand before you to speak on behalf of not only a co-worker, but a friend. Theoa and I entered each other's lives about 13 years ago when I transitioned back here to work at Southwest Georgia United and found him in place as the maintenance supervisor. Now, anybody that knows Theo know that there was nothing about anybody house that Theo didn't know about. He knew where the cutoffs were. He knew where this was. He knew where that was. You could call him night or day and say, Theo, I can't find this. Where he used to go out in the backyard and look to the left. That was just Theo. And in all of that, he was not only good-hearted and kind, he was honest and true. He was always there whenever you need him. You could believe what he said at any given time. But for those years, I was just blessed to have crossed paths with him because he was more than that, more than just a co-worker to me. He was my friend. I'm a single woman and here in Cordele and didn't have anybody to do this, that, or the other things that I couldn't do or I didn't know. I called Theo. Theo, can you help me do this? He'd be there. Theo broke down on 280. He'd be there. Theo, I need this, he'd be there. And he never grumbled, he never complained. He was just who he was. And just looking out at each and every one of you, I know that you know the love that he shared with each and every one of you, that he touched so many lives throughout this city, that he really left a legacy here and he will be sorely missed. If we only had a few more like Theo, I just thank God for sharing his life with us and thank you for this opportunity. Thank you. God bless you.
The family tribute, I nailed it. To those of us who really knew him, can attest that he was a cool, calm, quiet, caring, and gentle spirit. He was observant more than the eye could see. He watched all of us, both you and me. I will share with you what he said and would say if he could speak today. Bobby and Vaughn, I tried hard to tell each of you that I was slipping away. I told the both of you about Uncle Happy that day. He was sitting on the foot of my bed. I told him, I'm happy to get off my bed and get out of here. I also told the both of you of Johnny coming to visit a time or two. Johnny Zane came back a time or two. Well, we all knew that they were both dead. You looked at me with wide-stretched eyes. You looked at me if I had lost my mind. I looked at the both of you and I smiled. me if you must, but not for long. My request is for you to take care of my grandchildren and my weak little ones. Vine, my daughter number two. Baby girl, Papa's really going to miss you. I know you're going to miss me too. Thanks for all you did and do. You spoiled me when I was a kid too. I love you with the tenderest part of my heart. I know you're going to miss me a lot. Take care of Mark and Jar. Ted and Payday thought they were very smart. Michael, my heartbeat number three, the spitting image of me. Remember, I really love you. I love you, son, and that little and your little army that you have formed. Tell my grand and great grand that Grandpa loved them too. Bobby, oh Bobby, my love for you has always been the strongest for sure. When you were born, I was 12. It was only us two. I've always been proud to be your brother. You're the best little sister there ever could be. You were the youngest by far, but you always looked out and took care of me. Smile, Bobby. Smile, Bobby. Sometimes you have to be with my mom. I love you, Rosalie number two. You're not my mom. My brother-in-law, man, oh man, you and I always see eye to eye. But like general, we shook hands and respected each other. And that's no lie. We shared the same lady who was the apple of our eye. You were talkative and loud, and I was quiet. But brother-in-law, I love you and appreciate it. The assistance you provided too. My last request to you, my last visit to the garden club, I asked you for a simple Canadian miss. But the boss lady, my little sis, heard my request and said no. And that was the end of that, we both know. To my son-in-law, Carrie, you treated me like I was your dad. Just like your wife, you spoiled me just as bad. You were never too busy to stop and aid me. Thanks for all you did and do. You took me to my VA appointment with a near far. You chauffeured, fed, pushed wheelchair, and with my ears when I didn't understand what the VA doctor said. Please continue to take care of my baby girl and my grands. Well, most of y'all thought I only had three children, and that is partly true. I had a niece and a nephew, but I was their Uncle Daddy, for sure. Little Buddy and Jessica, I love the both of you. Little Buddy, I thought you were my oldest son, and that's the truth. Little Buddy, Uncle Lowe is really going to miss you. Pumpkin, Pumpkin, my darling honey baby niece. Three chambers of my heart belong to my children. The fourth chamber belongs to thee. I know you're going to miss me more than most. You were always there for me. The bond we share was bigger than our blood flow. Cry you must, but not for long. Uncle Lowe's not in pain. I'll lift my hand high above my head and praise our Father's holy name. Funky love, I am free. To my only goddaughter, Niecy, this is for you. I thank Uncle Heaven I paid for allowing me to help name you. Thanks for all you did and do down through the year. You never got birthday, Father's Day, Christmas gift, the visit, the card, and the call, and all the words of cheer. I cherish them forever, always my dear. My three biological aunts, I love you from the bottom of my heart. When I could no longer drive, Papa would bring me by to see you, and I was happy as I can be. Annette, over the years, I really enjoyed visiting you, Pete, and the kids. And Jim, the youngest of the three, I truly enjoyed visiting to Jacksonville. You opened up your home to me. To all my cousins, the Tolbert, the Bills, and the Jones, just to name a few, namely Willie Jane, David, Ben, and Walt Brown, you were my original crew. I really love all of my family, each and every one of you. To my dear buddy girl, Ruby Lucas, I'm talking to you. Thanks for being there, helping Bobby take care of me. I know you're going to miss me. Yes, my friend, I'm sitting on the banks of the river under the elm tree, patting my legs just like you accused me. waiting to cross over into eternity. To all my God and Club crew, Anne, Dee, Ruben, Jimmy, Chanel, B, TC, EJ, Ruby, Vesta, Bobby, and Nan. I just want all of you to know that I'm on my way to join the three original Garden Club crew, Paul, Johnny James, and Uncle Happy, over on the other shore. We all know, well, Vesta, I know you will always remember me when you walked through your red door, the one I painted for you many years ago. Elder Shadow the Dog, my former co-worker and friend, please tell everyone for me I nailed it. I live to be the promised age, 3 score years and 10, plus the bonus 8. Tell them I have no more pain, no more sorrow, no more worries for tomorrow. I'm free. Tell them I had my hammer. I have it in the morning. Tell them I had my hammer. I have it in the evening. Tell them I have it I love all over the land. Tell them I have it I love between a brother and my sister. Tell them I have it I love for my children and my grandchildren. Tell them I have it I love for my family and my friends all over the land. Tell them for me, family and friend, I'm free. I'm free. I nailed it and I'm free.
Good morning to the pastors and ministers present and to the bereaved family. Resolutions and loving memory of veteran Theodore Roosevelt Tolbert. No matter what your trials are or how big your mountain may seem, the Lord is there to see you through. He'll go through all extremes. So if your cross seems hard to bear and you know not what to do, the one who loves you the most will be there to see you through. The New Old World Baptist Church, Cordele, Georgia, Pastor W.W. Wilson, officers and members, extend our deepest sympathy to Sister Barbara and Lana Walker, who are dedicated members of the New Old World Baptist Church, in the loss of their loved one, veteran Theodore Tolbert. Be it resolved that the sympathy of this membership is extended to the family of veteran Tolbert, that you weep, not as you have no hope, but you commit yourselves to who is ever present, who both give it and take it away. To the family, we know your loss is deep and your sorrow is great, but we want you to know this loss is heaven's gain. Prayerfully submitted, the New Old World Missionary Baptist Church, Reverend W.W. Wilson, Pastor, Deacon Alonzo Jones, Chairman, Trustee Aletha Askew, Brother.
At this time, we'll have a musical selection by Mr. Kenneth Smith.
Amen. Amen. Amen again. Amen. Amen one more time.
Amen.
Amen. I was asked to stand in the place of Miss Janie and her daughter. Amen. What would I do? Again, giving honor to all the pastors and ministers, deacons, commissioner, shepherd, and to this beloved family. Even in a time like this, God is still good. And so if it's okay, since I was asked at the last minute, can we just have just a little church? And we just open it up just a little bit and have a little church. The song said, at the gate I know, yeah, there'll be somebody waiting at the gate I know. So if you don't mind, help me sing just a verse and we'll be out your way. At the gate I know, at the gate, oh, at the gate, gate I know, at oh,
will be waiting at the gate.
I know. Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus, who is the Christ, and to our family. Lord will be missed, but we have memories of him which we will cherish for a lifetime. And to Commissioner Shepherd, and to all the prolific proclaimers of the gospel, and to Deacon Parker and his staff, I greet you all in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus, who is the Christ. And as we have heard, the things about Theo, how he was an easy fella to get along with. He was always willing to help you, to lend a helping hand. And I remember as a lad how we would go to Wilcox County on Saturday and pick cotton for that man who used to work for named Mr. Lloyd. I didn't too much like that out there picking that cotton and in that cold weather when we get there, and then it'd be so hot, and Lord, I'd be glad when I don't have to pick no more cotton. And Dino, he was a great carpenter. He was great with his hands. I remember working with him down at Mr. Daniels. There was nothing Dino couldn't be him. He just take a look at it, oh, I can do that, you know? And that is great. But you know, Dino, he will be missed by his children, grand, and by his sister. You know, he was a great guy. He really was, you know, I can say that. And as I went to the hospital to visit Dino, my thing is, to check and see, have you accepted Jesus as your Savior? And Dino and I, we had conversations about the Bible. You know, and Dino said he accepted Jesus as his Savior. He said he had been done that a long time ago. Many may not remember, but Dino was the superintendent of the Sunday school at Mount Olive. You remember when he used to get up there on Sunday, he would call Wardman number one, Wardman number two. What we call Bug Hill. Yeah, he went to church back then. But you know, in time, you know, people may not go, but that don't mean they don't have a relationship with God. Because many that attend church don't have a relationship with God. They just go because of a habit. But this morning, I want to talk to you from Ecclesiastes chapter 3 and verse 1. And it said, to everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under the sun. And then I'll talk to you from this subject. A time called now. A time called now. Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for the life and legacy of our dear departed brother. And Father, we ask, Lord, that you give us a word on today that will bring comfort and soothe, oh Heavenly Father. Father, I ask you, oh Heavenly Father, to just give me preaching power for this moment, Father. And I hide myself behind that cross. This and all of the prayers I do pray in our Son Jesus' name, amen. The words of the preacher. They let us know that everything has its time. When one think about time, we think about the time on a clock, time on our calendars. But God, you know, God, he works outside of time, but he made time so that men could be able to judge their days. And as he separated the night from the day, he called the darkness night, and he called the day when the sun was out shining. And there are times in our life where we don't use our time appropriate. And many times we have said how time flies. Well, you the navigator of your time. It's up to you what you do with your time. But when we examine Galatians chapter 4, the Apostle Paul, letter to the church in Galactica. We also see where time is of great importance. It said,
in the fullness of time. Not at any time, but in the fullness of time, God sent forth his son. His son, which was born of a woman, born under the law. He was born to redeem all who was under the curse of the law. Well, I thank God that he was born, because I know I would still be alienated from God because of my sin nature. The nature which I inherited from our first father Adam in the garden. When he disobeyed God by eating of the forbidden fruit. How many times in our life have we done things that we know we shouldn't have done? And then we'll look back up our lives and say, why did I do that? Even a baby know right from wrong. They will try you. They will do things. And they will look up at you with them pretty puppy dog eyes, hoping that they could get by with what they have done. Well, many times we do God like that. We think we ain't got away with something. We may have gotten by, but we haven't gotten away. Because the Bible teaches us that the wages of sin is death. But I thank God that the gift of God is eternal life. All you have to do is be obedient and try to follow the word as close as possible. No, we are not perfect, but I know somebody who is perfect, and that is Mary's baby. When one began to look back over his or her life and began to wonder, how did I make it to a time called now? Well, to be honest and transparent, it wasn't because I was so good. It wasn't because I prayed so good. It wasn't because I dressed so good. But it was only by the grace and the mercy of God. Thank you, Jesus. Been a Vietnam combat veteran. He knew all too well what it meant to be in a time called now. He experienced and endured many hardships in the jungle of Vietnam. I would say, he witnessed many who started out with them at a time called now, but never lived to have another one. There were many that left the base camp with Dito. Went in the jungle on patrols. One thing Dito know about a time called now, because time is fleeing away. If you don't believe it, take a look at your watch. You will see that there is a time called now, and it is passing fast by us. Dito knew that danger was all around him, that death was there. In a time called now, you could either lose your life. Right now, a time called now, we could just follow and die and not see the next second, nor the next minute, nor the next day. But the Bible teaches us to number our days. Our David tells us that we are only one step away from death. So what are you going to do with your time called now? Are you going to make it represent where you spend eternity? Are you going to sit on the stool and do nothing and just let time pass you by? I'm telling you, it's time to make a move in the right direction. Look around us. There are so many killings going on. And here we are. We're on the brink of war. There are rumors of wars and wars. The Bible teaches about these things in the last days. We never thought that we would see things like that. We never thought we would see a pandemic, a virus that come through that taking so many lives. I tell you, take advantage of this time called now. David tells us that we are only one step away from death. But how you gonna walk this thing called life? I remember in the Old Testament, there was this man by the name of Enoch. Enoch, he didn't see his parents walk with God. He didn't see his daddy walk with God. But when Enoch got 65 years old, he had a boy baby by the name of Methuselah. That's when he began to walk with God. He walked with God because he didn't want his child to see him walking with the hoochies. He walked with God because he didn't want his tie to see him walking with a Chevy's Regal bottle turned up to his mouth. He walked with God because he wanted to show him that life is worth the living. And a man dies so that we can face tomorrow. Oh, don't let the children walk in contrary to God. At a time called now, how do you want to be remembered? Do you want to be remembered as someone who uses their time wisely? Because at a time called now, in James 4 and 14, he tells us that you do not even know what will happen on tomorrow, nor the next Sabbath. So what is your life? For you are a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes. But I'm here this morning, not to preach to Theodore, but to preach to my family and all that are present here on today. I want to know, do you know the man who walked the dusty trail of Jerusalem? Do you know the man who walked up Golgotha's hill? Do you know the man who carried my sins on his shoulder? Do you know the man who didn't have a boat, but he rode in a boat? Do you know the man that didn't have a manger, but was born in a manger? Do you know the man that never written a book, but there are many books that are written about this man? Do you know this man who can do everything except fail? But do you know this man who is able? Do you know this man who got all power in his hand? Do you know this man who was buried in a borrowed tomb? Do you know this man who got up on the third Sunday morning? Do you know the man who got up so that we can face tomorrow? Do you know this man called Jesus? And Matthew said, he is my king. And Luke said, he is my suffering servant. And Brother Mark, he said, this Jesus, a man, he is able to fulfill all imaginable things and things that are not imaginable. But when you ask Luke who this man is, he will say he is that great physician. And then when you ask John and say, John, who is this man? John would tell you that he is the word that was made flesh. And if you go to the book of Acts and say, well, who is this man? And somebody would tell you he is the Holy Ghost coming. But for me, he is the El Shaddai. He is the God that is more than enough. I know my Savior lives because I talked with him this morning. I know my Savior lives because he brought me from a mighty long way. But do you know this man? Do you know him? Do you know him? He is the lily of the valley. He is that bright and morning star. And do you know him? He gives you fleece. And do you know him? He sounds some strength. And do you know him? He is. He is. He's my midnight rider. And do you know this man? He is. He's my leading post. And do you know him? He's my water in dry places. And do you know him? And do you know this man? And do you know him? Yet people, they walk through life and they don't believe that he made a way when there was no way. But I know this man. I know him. I know him because he hung, bled, and died on yonder's cross. And he said, if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. And when the nails that kept Jesus up on that cross, are you familiar with John 3 and 16? It said, for God so loved the world that he gave us his only begotten son, that whosoever, whosoever, wedding nails. Jesus said, if you think I'm going to fight, nail my hands on the cross. If you think I'm going to run, nail my feet on there. But Jesus stayed on that cross, and ain't nobody died like my Jesus. From the sixth to the ninth hour, he stayed there. He stayed there for you, and he stayed there for me. He stayed there so we can have a time call now.
Oh, God. Thank you.